Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make this Halloween box, and it uses some of the new product out of the Holiday Mini Catalog. So let's get started. You're going to need a piece of 12 by 12 cardstock. Okay, so you're going to score it on one side at 3 and 9. And then you're going to turn it and score it at 4.5 and 7.5. So now you're going to fold it on all the score lines. Now what you want to do is keep your finger right here in this corner. And you're going to bring this score line here to this score line here, okay? So I'm going to be folding this in to this line, but I'm going to need to keep my finger there, okay? Because I don't want to go past that point. So fold that in, and then you're going to use your bone folder. Because you want that crease line good. Okay, so that's how it looks. Now I'm going to do this side. Once you've made a couple of these, you kind of get it down. It just takes a couple. And now this side. So you're going to do this 4 times. Okay, so here's our box. Now what I do is use some binder clips to hold it together. Okay, so what you're going to do is turn those lines that you just did, you created, just kind of push them back the other way. You do that so that you can just work with them, okay? So now I'm just going to hold that together with my clip. I'm not sure how well this looks using black cardstock on the video. Hopefully it's not making it blurry. Okay, so here's a key part to remember. See how this piece is this way and this piece is that way? So you want to make sure that on your ends that each one of them face in the same direction. Because like if you look at this box, see how they're both facing the back of the box? That's really what you would like to do, is have them facing the back. Okay, so here's my box. It measures 4.5 by 6, so it's a really nice box. I'm going to put the inside of the stapler, or the bottom of it, on the inside of the box and take it all the way in and then just staple. And that's why you see these cute little spiders over here. Okay, so now I'm just going to do this side. Okay, so the olive piece that goes on top of the box, this measures 5.75 by 4.25. The black piece of cardstock measures 5.5 by 4, and we're going to use the new spiderweb embossing folder that's in the Holiday Mini Catalog. So you're just going to put it right inside your folder, and then put it in between your two cutting pads. And there we have it. I'm just using a sponge with our frosted white. I'm just going to put a little bit on. Okay, so this is the piece that our rub-on is going to go on, and all you do, see, you can tell it lines up, so I'm just going to take my scissors and cut it out. Okay, and then I'm just going to line this up. I'm going to use a stylus to, I'm going to start in the center. Make sure there's no bubbles in there. Okay, I had to fast forward through that a little bit, but now it's all attached. Then you just peel that off, and there you have it. Okay, and then I just put a couple dimensionals on the back. I think two on the top and two on the bottom. Okay, and then attach it. And then next we're going to put the holes for the handles. Okay, so I'm going to use about 35 inches of the rebar tie wire. I'm just going to kind of guess what 35 inches is. Now, when you're working with this, make sure that you have a cloth close by because it has oil on it, okay? Okay, it's very greasy, so my fingers are going to kind of be black by the time I'm done. Okay, so I want to keep the end flat because that's what's going to go in my box, okay? So then you're just going to wrap this around your pencil and then pull it out. And then you want to make the shapes kind of fun and funky. You don't want them to all be the same. Okay, so here's my handle. You got to be okay with your fingers getting dirty for this, if you're using this stuff, because look, let's attach this to our box. Just going to turn the ends in and then press that over to the side. Okay, now we can either snip this with our wire cutters, or you can, if you leave enough room, you could actually twist it and push it downwards. Okay, so now let's go ahead and do this side. Now what I'm probably going to do on this is come in here and snip some of it off because it's sticking up right there and it could poke someone. So I'm just going to cut that off. This actually looks really cute. You just kind of play with it. If it seems too tall, then scrunch up some of the little curly things. See? It looks a little cattywampus or crooked or whatever you call it. Look. Looks good. I'm just going to snip these with the wire cutters. Make sure if you're doing this that you don't make that fly up and hit you. There's the piece I trimmed. Okay, so now all we have to do is tie the ribbon and the lace to the wire and add our spiders. Okay, so we're going to stamp the spider from the Dark and Dreary stamp set. And then we're going to color it using the old olive marker. And then we're going to cut it out. I'll warn you, I'm going to fast forward this part out, so I'm just going to cut as close to the image as I can without cutting it. Okay, so now that I have the spider cut out, I'm just going to put a mini glue dot on the bottom or the back side of it. And then just attach it right in the middle of the spider web. And you could put more than one if you'd like. Now we're just going to add the ribbon and the lace. So all I do is just take them together. I like leaving the ribbon long on this project. I just think it just does something. And I won't make you watch me do the other side because you've already seen the pictures of the finished box. So we'll just clean up the ribbon a little bit. And to make the crinkle paper, all this is just our cardstock using the tabletop trimmer. I do have a video on YouTube showing how to do that. So here they are. And if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks a lot. Bye.